everyone, welcome to VlossTube number 12. My name is Lydia, and it's been quite a while since I last filmed a video. I mentioned in my previous video that we were going to Denmark on holiday with my side of the family, and that I will film a little later due to that. But life got in the way, and so here I am filming today. Today is the 16th of November, and here in the Netherlands, Sinterklaas is coming, which is a national holiday, kind of it, something for children. You can compare it to Christmas a little bit. So Sinterklaas is coming to town, so we are going there in a little bit. So, but before that, I wanted to film a little video for you guys to give you an update. Yeah, Denmark was great. It was our first time ever going to Denmark, and we had a wonderful time. And we went to Legoland, which was amazing, even for us adults. And we surely want to go back someday because you have Lego house, which we didn't visit because there was no time. It was after the normal high season, we call it in the Netherlands. I don't know if you call it that way where you live, but during the week Legoland and also Lego house had limited opening hours, so we weren't able to go there. But we love the country, we love the little cottage, or little, it wasn't little, it was very big, we were in, and we love the surroundings, we love everything. So this will not be the last time we are going to Denmark. So, yeah, and now we're back, and it's time for an update. So, when we went to Denmark, I brought 3 projects with me. I brought my Quaker by Joke Trebbedenijs. I brought the Boxer from Thea Gouverneur. And I brought Hello Pumpkin from Caterpillar Cross Stitch. And we were just about 2 streets away from our house. And I was like, oh, I forgot all the flosses for my Hello Pumpkin. So my husband was like, well, should I go back? Do you want to get it? No, just keep on driving. You know, it is a 6-hour drive. So no, just keep driving. Stupid me. I still have 2 other projects. So due to that, I could stitch a lot on my Boxer in the car. And on the way there, I stitched a lot, and on the way back I didn't stitch a lot, I didn't feel like it. But I made quite a bit progress on him. And if I remember, somewhere in this frame there will be a picture of where I was last time. And this is where I am now. I've done a lot on the bottom. I only have to stitch a little bit here, and the rest is all finished. You can't quite see it because it's white on white. So, and then I can go back on the upper side of his head. So yeah, this is turning out very lovely, and I'm really growing on this. So tomorrow we are going to Friesland to my family-in-law, and then I will excuse me, I will bring this along with me to stitch a little more on it. And then we were there in Denmark a week, and since I'm only stitching on the Boxer in the car, which is my car, my traveling project, excuse me, I only stitched on my Quaker bij Joke Trebbe de Nijs. And guess what? Da 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 da! It's finished! I'm so happy. It turned out so great. It's so pretty. I still have to iron it. I still have to frame it. I have to look for a nice frame to put it in. And I think I want to do something with the browns inside or the green maybe. But I haven't found a perfect frame for it yet. So yes, this is finished. And I had someone replying to a picture of this one on Instagram. That she really loved the pattern, but she couldn't find it online. And she's living in America. And we talked a little bit through Instagram. And I decided to send it to her as, you know, happy mail. And so it's on your way. I don't know if you look at my videos, but it's on its way. And I hope you will have lots of fun with this one. Then I also participated in the October acrostics. But, you know, I had put the bar so high for all of the challenges. I almost, for every line, for every project, I filled in 1200 stitches, which is a lot. And I wasn't able to reach that. So when we got back from Denmark, I was like, well, okay, I put that aside. I will stitch on what I want and I will see again in November. And then I will lower the bar for myself. So I stitched a little bit on my Valfairy, quite a bit actually, which means I have a page finish. Yay! I finished this page, and as you can see, I'm using Pattern Keeper, so I finished the threads because I am stitching cross country. So I went a little bit outside of the page, but that's okay. And yeah, I'm really happy with this one. But then, because I like to stitch from right to left, I stitch in a hoop but in hand. Maybe I will make a video one day of how I stitch. So I decided I am starting in this side of the project and, you know, work my way in. Because that's how I work. I work this way. So I was coming along very nicely. Made quite a bit progress on this page. And then I saw it. I made a mistake. A very big mistake. And I couldn't fudge it. I couldn't work my way around it. I made a mistake in Pattern Keeper. Because these pages I'm using, I have a large format. And they don't... you know, Pattern Keeper uses the original pages. I made a mistake. And so I colored too much in Pattern Keeper. But that's why I thought I was further along. So I'm missing about this piece. And I already started frogging it. As you can see, all loose threads, because it's so small, it's a pain in the ass to work your way through it. So I'm doing a little bit every time I'm feeling like it. So, and then I will start over. Then I also stitched a little bit on my Farewell to Anger. I will move my needle minder. The other needle minders you see in this video are available in my Etsy shop. So if you like the needle minders, please follow the link below. And then you will find them. This is my Farewell to Anger. And I'm working on the third page. This one I don't have a pattern keeper yet, because I received the paper copy on my birthday last year. But when Hate is having a sale, I am definitely buying this as a PDF, so I can use pattern keeper for this, because I can work a little bit faster with pattern keeper. I really like it. So but under that, I will keep blowing away because this one is very confetti heavy, but I love it. So this is Farewell to Anger by Leonid Afrimov. And then I have my third hate, which I also worked a little bit on, and this one I do have in pattern keeper. And this is my mini owl in Poppy Field, and I'm over halfway through the first page. I think I'm 2/3 in, and this is pink, 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 all the way. But it's so cute. You can see the sky here. I love this one. I'm mostly, you know, working my way around those three. And then when I'm bored with all the pinks, I put this aside and get something else. So, colors get a little bit washed away, but... And this is also an 18 count. And I decided when I am going to start another hate, I am going to try 25 count Lucana. I believe that is where Jemima is stitching on, the rocking stitcher. And I love how that turns out, so I'm thinking about, you know, trying that. But I have three on the go, so I will be busy for a few years, so we'll see when that will happen. And then here is my small sampler by Lila Studio, and I don't know if I have shown this the last time, but I actually made quite a bit progress on this one too. So if I have showed it already, I'm sorry, then you can skip this. But here is where I am now, and I love this one. This is the first time for me stitching on with 30 gold gentle arts. And I love working with them. It is amazing to stitch with. So from this project on, I have some more projects which I am stitching with gentle arts. So I love this. I need to get back to this one. I love it. And then it was excuse me, it was the 1st of November, so I could start working on the November acrostics. I didn't print out the printable because our printer was out of ink, so I wrote it down, and I have made a decision to work on more projects that were laying around a little bit, so I could, you know, finish them and maybe start something new. So since I finished my Quaker, I thought I could start something new. And it's kind of ironic, I started this one, Midnight Watch, on the 1st of November, the day after Halloween. My daughter is born on Halloween, so we had a very, very busy day. So I could start it on the 31st of October. But I started this one on the 1st of November, and this will give me time to finish it in time for Halloween 2020, I suppose. So I am stitching this on 28 count Brittany, Lucana, in the colorway Light Taupe, with all the colors for flosses. And I already stitched 480 stitches on this one, and that is why I have, let me fold this a little bit, that is why I have a loose thread here, because I stopped at 480. I started working on the border, and I am stitching the orange thingies also because I like that. Some of you I heard are not stitching those. And I started working on the moon behind the cat. Here. So that's 480 stitches on Midnight Watch. And I really, really love this. And I love stitching on the 28 count. This is my first time stitching. No, it's not my first time stitching on 28 count. I'm lying because my, if I can get it, my Quaker by Joke Trebbeden Nijs, yep, is also 28 count. But I love stitching on this. So I am looking around to kit up some more projects, and I am, when I do, I will also be using 28 count because it works very nice. And I love this color. So that's that one. So that's finished. Then I grabbed a little package which I once bought in a bookstore we have called Boekenvoordeel. They sometimes sell cross stitch patterns for cheap, and I bought this years ago, and I wanted to stitch this for my grandmother one day, but before I could finish this she passed away and I never stitched on it again. So but I now took it out and I also stitched 480 stitches on this. I finished up the top part of the basket because there were a lot of holes to fill in, and I started working on the flowers, and I still have some blanks there. Then I have to finish this kitty and the lower part of the basket, but that will be for the next acrostic. So that's that. And then I have one more project to show you, which is a UFO. I am not going to finish this one, sadly, but true. I was working on this the other night, and I actually started to like it a little bit more. And you know, the finish line is not far along. But then I saw I made a mistake. This is My Lavender Fairy by DMC. I stitched this, and then I was working on her arm. This is, I hope you can see it, this is her underarm, this part. But then I figured this, where I ended, should be there next to this brown piece. So I'm way off, way, way off. And I was looking if I could, you know, fudge my way around it, but it will look terrible if I, you know, I will shorten her arm and it will look terrible. If I want to frog this, I have to frog all these French knots. And since this is a project I have a hate-love relationship with, I'm not going to finish this one. I'm not. I'm sorry. But that's it. So, since the pattern is by DMC, and it is an older pattern, it has all the DMC, I hope you can see this, color numbers behind it. So I will show you a little bit. I marked this one with a gray pencil, and I still have some leftover flats. So if there is anyone who would love to stitch this, I will be giving it away. Please respond below if you would like to stitch this. I will send it to you anywhere around the world without shipping. See, you can see it as some sort of giveaway. So tell me if you like to stitch it. If there are more than one, then I will randomly pick one. Pick someone using a number generator or, you know, a comment generator. So please let me know if you want to stitch this. You only have to make sure you get Ada or any other fabric you would like to use. You will get the leftover threads, which I always put around the card, but you can still use it. It's not much left since I already was a lot in the project, but you could still use this one. And then you can add your own DMCs. So everything is still there. Explanation of how you stitch the front, the pattern, and some of the threads. So if you would like to stitch this, please comment that you would love to stitch this. And if I pick you, I will ship it to you. So, and I will pick someone next video I'm filming, so that will be in about two and a half weeks. So that's that. And maybe if you would like to have this with it, you just have to say it and I will send it along. So that's it for my whips. Maybe I forgot something, I don't know, but then I will show it to you in the next video. In my latest video, I forgot to show some haul, so I'm showing this today, but I don't have any haul further than what I'm showing now. I wanted to go to the Christmas days of the Handwerk Boutique. She has a sort of sale going on every year, but something happened and I wasn't able to go. So, but on the other hand, it's almost the 4th of December. And then I will be also at the Handwerk Boutique meeting a lot of other Flusstubers, and I'm so excited. You know, cross-stitch isn't the craft which is alive like it is in America. So I don't know a lot of stitchers. I know my mom, but that's it. And I'm very happy that I can meet some of you, which I know through the internet, and make a nice day out of it, and stitch, and meet you know, the designers of Twin Peak Primitives, and yes, and Pema Steph, of course. You know, this will be a little fangirl day. So yeah, I'm curious, what will you bring to a retreat? I mean, I see this as a little retreat. What would you normally bring? Would you bring your large projects? Would you bring finishes? Would you bring your favorite projects? Would you bring several projects? Please let me know. So, haul, that's where I started talking about. I ordered a little light on AliExpress, because where I'm sitting on the couch, a little in the corner, I do have a light shining from behind, but it's not very bright. And I decided I want to buy a floor stand light. I've seen a nice one in IKEA, but you know, you have the storage that when you're not stitching, and you cannot leave it standing there because it's not something that fits in my room to fit with the rest of the furniture. So I decided to order a little light. This is a clip-on, which is actually used for books, and I thought, well, I could clip it on my ring or my hoop, and you know, you turn it on and it has a little light, but this keeps snapping off the ring, so this isn't quite what I was looking for. But this was about €1.20, so okay, maybe I can make it work differently, but I haven't found yet on what way. And then I have one little pattern I bought of a stash of or a de-stash Facebook group here in the Netherlands. This is Liz Kate snippets. I can drive a stick, and I believe I saw this at Stitch the Stash. Deborah, correct me if I'm wrong. And I thought this was really, really cute, and I could buy this for €1.50. So of course I had to have this, and I'm going to stitch this for Halloween next year. So, and I am looking more and more at Lizzie Kate patterns. I really like them, so this will not be my last one. So, for plants, I am continuing working on my 24 hours of cross stitch, acrostic, and I still have a lot more to do. And I have filled in everything with 480 stitches, so I will be able to finish those. I'm currently working on my giraffe with his little young. So, that's it actually. Maybe I will film a little bit before the mini retreat, and if I'm not able to, I will see you afterwards. So if you're going to the Handwerk Boutique, I hope to see you there. I'm very happy to meet you, and we will have a wonderful day, I suppose, even though I'm a little bit nervous of meeting you all. I'm so looking forward to it. So thank you all for watching, and I hope to see you again very soon. Happy stitching! Bye!